Greetings, 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 one and all. God bless you all. Welcome, welcome. This is Angela Hunt here with another word for you. This is indeed an on-time word from my Father in heaven. This is a word for every person under the sound of my voice. This is a word for 2023. Do you feel stuck in life? Are you tired of the same old? Do you want your story to change? Do you want your life to move forward? If your answer is yes, then you are in the right place and this message is just for you. Go ahead and hit the like button and share. Share with family and share with friends. Now, in order to record positive changes in your life this year, you have a major role to play. You will have to make a move. You will have to do something. The Lord wants you to step out and step forward this year. He wants you to step out and step forward by doing new things and exploring new things. Many of us have been limiting our lives, abilities, and destinies because we refuse to make a move. Why do you refuse to make a move? We refuse to step out and step forward. But I'm here to tell you today that if you do nothing, then nothing will happen. You see, fear is the number one factor that cripples one's ability and willingness to step out and step forward. Fear is a barrier or a limitation wall. Fear allows people to shy away and do nothing, and then they get stuck in one place, the same place year after year after year. Is fear holding you back? Is fear crippling your ability to move forward? Then I command the Spirit of the Living God to bind every spirit of fear within you. 2 Timothy 1 verse 7 says, "For God had not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind." My lovely family, the spirit of fear is not of God. So if you are feeling fearful today, you better bind and rebuke that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, somebody. This spirit of fear is often used by the devil to rob one from fulfilling his or her true potential. Fear has caused so many persons to miss out on opportunities, blessings, and breakthroughs. Hallelujah, somebody. If you talk to some people, you can hear all the types of fears that they have. You have fear of swimming, fear of driving, fear of heights, fear of crowd, fear of public speaking, fear of failure, fear of being alone, fear of what people may say or do, and it goes on and on. So many fears, and the enemy has been using fears to hold back people, to stop people from moving forward. But God gave me this message to come and tell you today that it is time to step out and step forward. Hallelujah, somebody. So you see, fear is a weapon of the enemy. You see, fear tells you no, you can't do it. Fear tells you no, you are going to fail. Fear tells you no, you are wasting your time. Fear tells you no, people are going to laugh and mock at you. Fear tells you no. But I'm here to tell you today that God says yes in the name of Jesus Christ. God gave us a bold and courageous spirit, Rebecca Shandalabasata, and you need to remember that whatever you're doing, you're not alone. God is with you. You see, no one ever make significant progress in life by staying in the same place or staying in the same position every year doing the same routine. You have to do something different this year to attain different results. Hallelujah. To step forward means to make progress. Forward movement. Hallelujah. Many of you have made the declarations from the beginning of this year that you want God to do new things. You want your life to move forward. You have written all your resolutions. Hallelujah, somebody. But you will have a role to play. You will have to step out. You will have to do what God tells you to do in the name of Jesus. You see, fear of stepping forward will keep you in poverty. fear of stepping forward will keep you in the tail position when Deuteronomy 28 verse 13 tells us that we should be the head and not the tail. Fear of stepping forward will keep your life stuck and stagnated. Maybe that's why your life is so stagnated. You haven't been stepping out boldly and you haven't been stepping forward. Glory be to God. You have to step forward to move to the next level. You have to step forward to unlock new opportunities, new places, and new things. You have to step forward to conquer your fears and conquer your enemies. You have to step forward to make impact. You have to step forward to stay ahead of your enemies. Praise God. Hallelujah. I am encouraging you this year that whatever it is that God has laid upon your heart, whatever gifts and talents that God has given you, whatever God is unctioning you to do, I command you to bind every spirit of fear and step out this year. Your blessing is attached to you stepping out. Your connections are attached to you stepping out. Your success is attached to you stepping out and stepping forward. Let us now look at the story where Pharaoh and his army were chasing the Israelites. So this is Exodus 14 verses 8 to 5. Now God had hardened the heart of Pharaoh and his army. So they started to chase the Israelites with all their might and with all their strength. Now when the children of Israel looked and saw that the Israelites were catching up to them, the scripture says that they became greatly afraid and they started to cry out to God. My God, after crying out to God, then they started to murmur and to complain, saying unto Moses, why did you bring us out here in the wilderness to be killed? Weren't there enough graves in Egypt? My God, my God. But in verse 15 of the text, the Lord spoke to Moses. Said the Lord spoke to Moses. Lord spoke to Moses in Exodus 14 verse 15. And the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. My God, my God, you heard it. Go forward. God told Moses to tell the people to go forward. In other words, keep moving. Now is not the time to stop or surrender. You cannot get to the promised land by surrendering. You cannot get to the promised land by staying in one place. You have to make a move, step out and step forward. My God, my God. But this message is also for you today. This message is also for you under the sound of my voice. God is telling you that if you want new things in your life this year, you better get bold and courageous. You better step out and step forward. Roboko Shandala. God is saying, step out to do that new thing that I have laid on your heart. Step out and start that business. I have already given you the idea. Step out and start praying for people. I have already anointed you. Step out and go back to school. You can do it and I will help you. Step out and start using the gifts and talents that I have given to you. God says, why are you hiding your gifts and talents? If you keep them hidden, then they will not work for you. Proverbs 18 verse 16 says that your gift will make room for you. But if you're hiding your gifts would not make any room for you. God says by using the little gifts and talents that he has given you, he will give you more. To whom much is given, much is required. Come on, somebody. Instead of sitting down on your gifts, use it this year to move your life forward. Use it this year, Makorebeko Shandala Bahai, to step out and step forward into new territories, into new levels, into new dimensions. Maribia rubundu akaskalande lebegada roboko shandala basatai kuskulundu aribia surianda. I just want to share just my little experience here that I personally am not an upfront person. I'm a person who loves to blend in the crowd, blend in the background. And when God had commissioned me to do a YouTube channel, my God, I got a little scared. I got a little afraid because I don't too like cameras like that. And to be on camera where people are staring at you, looking down my throat, looking down my mouth. But I did this out of strict obedience because God instructed me to do it. So whether or not I like it, whether or not I am afraid, I did it out of strict obedience. And I can say today that I am happy that I stepped out to start this channel because I'm seeing impact. People's lives are being impacted. People's lives are being blessed by the content on this channel. And I do not know what future God has for this channel, what helpers he might bring, supporters, we don't know. But if Angela Hunt International Ministries is not out there, then the help that the ministry needs will not come. So what I am saying, that you have to make a move. Come on, somebody. The thing that you are afraid of, your blessing could be wrapped up in that thing. Many persons who you see are successful in business or ministry or so on, they had to start. They had to step out and make a move. And I speak here of Joyce Myers. She has been very integral in my younger years of Christianity. My God, and I know her story very well. She was what we'd call unusual. She said with even her type of voice that is as hoarse as a man, people were saying she's not suited for ministry, but she stepped out and stepped forward. And today Joyce Myers is a great woman of God who is known globally across the world. Her unique voice, once you hear it, you know it is Joyce Myers because it stands out. She says in her area when she started ministry, women were not supposed to be preaching, so she got a lot of fight, but she still stepped out and stepped forward. Today Joyce Myers have written over 100 bestseller Times books. My God, they are translated into almost every language on this earth. People are being impacted by her ministry. She has a rough past of where she was raped by her father, but she didn't allow that to stop her from stepping out and stepping forward when God has called her to ministry. Now, because of her obedience to step out and step forward, her life has changed drastically. She's well been known. She's making impact. She's touching lives. She's changing lives. Had she not stepped out and stepped forward, would we even know who Joyce Myers is? If she hadn't stepped out and stepped forward, would we even have a book of hers? Come on, somebody. I am here to encourage you today. What gifts and talents have God given you? It doesn't have to be in preaching or in ministry. You may be good at cooking or baking. You may be good with your hands. You may be good with encouraging persons. God says this gift, you need to start using it because it will make room for you. This gift will open new doors for you. And I know God wouldn't give me this message if there are not persons under the sound of my voice who God has been speaking to make a move. But fear has been crippling your ability to move. If you are one of those persons, I want you to comment in the comment section what God had told you to do. And is it fear that is causing you not to move? I pray for you today that you will get the boldness and the courageousness of God. I pray for you today that you will rise out, step out, and step forward in order for things to change in your life, in order for new things to be birthed in your life. You have to do some new things in the name of Jesus. When you step out and step forward, then God will hold your hand, he will guide you, and he will protect you. As I'm about to close out this message, you may be saying, woman of God, how do I overcome this fear? And I have three tips for you. The number one thing to overcome fear, you have to trust God. You have to know that you are not alone. You have to know that if nobody else is with you, nobody else is supporting you, that God is with you. Isaiah 41 verse 10 says, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. So if you hold on to the promises of this scripture, my God, God will help you through, knowing you're not alone. So why are you being fearful? Proverbs 3 verse 5 to 6 says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. So with God by your side, He will lead you and He will direct you. You just have to keep putting your trust in God. God is not going to tell you to do something that He's not going to help you with. God is not going to tell you to go to a territory, go and do something in which He will not assist you. The second tip is that you have to remember that God is your strength. You are not doing it in your own strength. Philippians 4 verse 13, I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. So no matter how hard the thing seems or how unusual the thing seems, you have to remember that God is your strength, and with God, you can do all things. The third tip is do it afraid. Yes, you heard me. It is okay sometime to feel fearful. It is okay sometime to feel a little nervous, but you have to step out and step forward. You have to do it afraid. God still wants you to make a move even if you feel afraid, and you will find out that by doing it over time, this fear starts to go. Again, I take you back to Joyce Myers. A few years ago, I read a book that she wrote called Do It Afraid. This book has really impacted my life. Glory be to God that it is okay sometime. Many times you see people who are doing public speaking, sometimes they are fearful and nervous at first, but by the time they get up there and start to get into their message, fear goes away. Hallelujah, praise God, praise God. So fear of failure has been crippling you from moving forward. Fear of failure has been causing many not to move forward in life. Some of you are there saying, God, help me, God, help me. But God is saying, I have already given you the tools. I have already given you the gifts and talents. I have already given you the vision. If you don't step out and step forward, then nothing will happen and nothing will change. Hallelujah, praise God. And if you fail, at least you know you would have tried. You would have given it your best shot. If you go forth and you fail, then you would have learned some mistakes. So you will not commit these same mistakes again the next time around you try. And as I was jotting down a few notes here, I heard Aaliyah's song. She has passed on. She was a popular R&B singer. Song says, at first you don't succeed, dust yourself off and try again. If at first you don't succeed, dust yourself off and try again. And this is a person from the secular world. This wasn't a Christian, but they know the principles that you have to keep trying. Glory be to God. So even if you fail, get up and try again. Hallelujah, somebody. I'm rounding up my message now. I hope this message has blessed you. I want you to do a self-evaluation of yourself now to see what is it that God has laid upon your heart to do. What is it that God has been telling you to do? Let this message resonate in your heart and your spirit. May it give you fuel and strength to step out and step forward and do what God has commissioned you to do. Step out and step forward so you can come out of poverty. Step out and step forward so you can step into new opportunities, new connections, new places, and new things. You have to make a move knowing that God is with you, and with God all is possible, and with God He will strengthen you. My lovely family, you are blessed and highly favored. I bless you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Go forth, step out and step forward this week. Go forth, step out and step forward this year and record positive changes in your life. It is time to get up. It is time to come out of that hiding place. It is time to let your light so shine that men can see your good works. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.